السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we'll be talking about my third visit to Sudan 1985, and this was following a very adventurous journey of Hajj. At the time I was the president of Egyptian Student Union on the national level, and I was not sponsored by the government. That's why the embassy was not very happy with me. How dare I could become the president of the Egyptian Student Union or society in the country. Our program during the 1985 was to do a Hajj trip for the members of the union, the student, to do a trip to Paris and to make competition for Quran recitation and memorization, and to produce a new magazine called The Egyptians. We did the three of them, or the four of them, alhamdulillah. And but we have difficulty, especially for the people to sponsor our stay inside the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia during the Hajj period. We booked the tickets. Oh, we decided first of all not to take families with us, but to go as individual young people. We were about five or six of us, and this is number one. Number two is we booked our tickets on Egypt Air, but the embassy was not very happy and told Egypt Air in Birmingham to cancel the booking. But the manager or the director was very nice man, and he told us about this and told us, I'm going to cancel it, but please, I don't want to spoil your Hajj, go and find yourself another airline. We respected the man, and we were looking for some other airline to take us to Saudi Arabia to do the Hajj. And I, as a chairman or as the president of the Egyptian Student Union, I was very secretive even with the member of the delegation who were traveling with me, and did not disclose the name of the airline company, being afraid that actually a communication between the embassy in London and this company will actually lead to another cancellation and we spoiled the journey. We failed actually to find somebody to host us and to give us accommodation in the in Mecca and Medina. Then an idea came to me to talk to one of the colleagues of my father, whom was like my uncle, and he was a minister of Al-Azhar affair during the time of Al-Sadat and Jihan Mubarak and Jihan Sadat time. And I told him about our plan to go to make Hajj in during that time, and would like to go and live in the residence or stay in the residence of the Tekiya, the Egyptian residence, or the Egyptian Tekka or Tekiya. Said, okay, my son, send me the name of the delegation and they will talk to the Minister of Waqf. So to be very honest, I have only six people on my list, but I wrote a list which contained about 20 people just to tell them the importance of this. I invented the names and they put the names, and I gave it to one of our colleagues who just passed his PhD exam. I was going to Egypt, and I asked my brother to meet him in the airport and to take the list from him and send it to the colleague of my father, Sheikh Abdul Aziz, rahmatullah alayh. Sheikh Abdul Aziz was having his breakfast in his house on the day that my brother arrived to him. And after he finished his breakfast, he went straight to the Ministry of Awqaf to meet the Minister of Awqaf. His name is, was and is, because he's still alive, Ahmadi Abu Noor, Dr. Ahmadi Abu Noor, who incidentally, with the Qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has been visited by the head of the delegation of the Egyptian delegation going to make Hajj on behalf of the Ministry of Awqaf, which was actually one of the generals. His name was Sufi, I think. His name was Sufi something. And my uncle, or the friend of my father, gave the list to the minister, and the minister gave the list to the head of the delegation. And he told them, yes, sir, I will be hosting them, inshallah, in Mecca and Medina. Alhamdulillah, our plan is to go to Mecca first, Then after we finish Hajj, we go to Medina, because the Egyptian usually go to Medina first and then to go afterward to Mecca for Hajj. And we arrived there, and I did not disclose the name of the airline company till we arrived to the Heathrow Airport, when we were actually going to the checking in desk with the Sudanese airline. And we went on the plane. It was very, not a very good service at that time. And there was a fight on the plane between a Sudanese Haji and, not a Sudanese, an Asian Haji and Sudanese air stewards. And he was insulting her in a very bad way. And this was actually memorable for me. I never saw somebody going to do Hajj and insulting a woman on the airplane. We landed in Jeddah, the Jeddah airport for Hajji, and I was told, please, now you go and see if we have got a space to stay in the Tekiya or not. I was walking with very heavy feet. I did not want to reach the telephone to call the administrator in the residence. By the time I reached the telephone and the call, the man on the other side, and when he said, yes, sir, we are waiting for you, this gave me my life back again. And they came back with a different face to the face that I left my colleague there. And we stayed in the most enjoyable 2 weeks in Mecca and Medina to enjoy our stay inside the Tekiya, the Egyptian Tekiya in both cities. On the way back, I stopped in Khartoum and tried to visit Sudan for the third time, 1983, 84, 85. Third time, and at the time I was going to see, to view the project of the chicken farm, which was made especially for the Eritrean refugees in Khashm al-Girba in east of Sudan. And we took the car from the local organization and we drove about 6 or 7 hours, but unfortunately the car stopped all of a sudden because there was no petrol in it, and we have to sleep overnight on the main road. There was no communication, there was no telephone communication till the next morning. And me and my colleague were actually sleeping on the floor, actually, not on the floor, on the main road, on the side of the road. The following day, I think he sent a message with some of the passengers or some of the cars going to Al-Gadarif. And the people came and brought some petrol for us and took us there to the area there, alhamdulillah. And we were very welcomed by the local community. And slaughtering, I think, a goat or a sheep. And it was the first time to eat a raw liver with what we call it umfitfit. Sudanese will know this, the raw liver and the stomach and all this sort of thing. And we visited the project and the chicken farm, which out of the sales of the eggs and the chicken will be spending the money for the cause of education of the Eritrean refugees in the area. This was our first project to be implemented in East Sudan for the Eritrean refugees at that time, and alhamdulillah it was successful so far. And this was my first experience to travel to see a proper development project in this area done by our local organization. And the story goes on for other journeys to Sudan as well and other countries. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.